Hello and welcome to the awesome TV show with Nikhil Taneja. As I mentioned last time, there are way too many TV shows streaming every month. So this section tells you what's streaming online in India and where. This is also a section where I'll read out your reviews of TV shows because I love you. Before you check out this list, please check out my list of the top 5 shows of May here. And here are the shows that didn't make it to that list. On Netflix, Safe. Remember Michael C. Hall from Dexter? Well, he's done some intermittent indie work, but he's back on television with a British mystery thriller called Safe. And it's quite decent and very binge-worthy. I didn't count it in my top 5 of the month because, well, a girl goes missing in the show and the police seems least interested and the father, a surgeon, is trying to find her. It's such an obvious loophole, yeah. The Rain. I enjoyed the Danish post-apocalyptic thriller The Rain, even though it's like a weird cross between The Walking Dead, Fear the Walking Dead, Lost, The Leftovers, and Rain, because the premise is very interesting. Rain kills people. Explained. Netflix has tied up with Vox for a video series called Explained that explains, in 20 minutes, a variety of topics from monogamy to K-pop to cryptocurrency. It makes me smarter after every episode. The Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt season 4 and Fawda season 2 are also out, but I stopped watching the former and haven't yet watched the latter, so hey, you get to review them for me. Also, has anyone yet seen The Break with Michelle Wolf? Is it good? By the way, you should also totally watch an Indian stand-up special by Hari Kondabulu, Warn Your Relatives, because it's super topical and very well done. Look up his documentary, The Problem with Apu, later. On Amazon, I finished watching The Terror after all your recommendations and it's brilliant and you should totally watch it. If you haven't seen The Looming Tower, you should totally watch that too. I've stopped watching both Madam Secretary and Elementary a couple of seasons ago, but season 4 and season 6 of the shows are out respectively, so in case you're interested, go for it. On Hotstar, Trust came to an end and it wasn't as perfect as the first half, but I still think it's one of the stronger shows of the year. On the other hand, I've sort of changed my feelings towards both Silicon Valley and Barry after their seasons ended. I actually really liked the last two episodes of Silicon Valley because they were so much plot again and hence so much fun again. But Barry became a black drama from a black comedy, so I'm not really sure if I enjoyed it so much towards the end. By the way, is anyone watching I'm Dying Up Here season 2? Let me know what you think. And now, it's time for your reviews. On Netflix, many of you recommended Safe. Nisarg Shah says, it's a good mystery drama and Hall has managed to pull off the accent really well. The British accent, he means. Nisha Work said, it's addictive and interesting, while Sakshi Mohindra found it really engaging. The Rain had mixed reactions though. Achin Jain said, The Rain sucks big time. It's like amateur actors making some shit. The story is decent, but execution is terrible. Akash Crispin kept it concise. Don't watch The Rain show. It's awful. Stop watching after episode 3. Akhilin C, on the other hand, said The Rain was pretty good actually, not as impactful as Dark, but still quite compelling and keeps you hooked. In recommendations, Achin Jain recommended La Chalet. It's a French series, kinda like Agatha Christie, but the treatment is fresh and they kept the suspense till the very last episode. Medha Chatterjee recommended Troy. It's fun cause it gives me desi masala feels, but it feels too rushed and way too shallow, and guilty pleasure would be the only reason you would want to watch it. Avinash Ajarapu recommends Bobby Kennedy for President. It's an excellent show. It charts his life from being his brother's campaign manager to his unexpected death. Do check it out. It's worth watching. On Amazon, I found the pilot of Deception just about okay, but Trusted King said, Deception dude, it's awesome. How do you miss it? Well, if he's trusted and he's a king, maybe we should give it a shot. Mayank Agarwal also trusts him. You said that it's okay, but believe me, I've watched all episodes till now and loved it. Do give it a try too. Many of you, including Sovik, Subir Majumdar and Adhiraj Styles, recommended Cobra Kai. Guess what? It's my number one show from May. Check out my previous episode here. By the way, a lot of you have also recommended Killing Eve, Patrick Melrose and a bunch of other shows. But these shows aren't legally streaming in India and we only talk about awesome TV shows that are legally streaming in India. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm not going to recommend brilliant illegal TV of May every month starting this month with Killing Eve, Patrick Melrose, The Good Fight, oh my god, The Good Fight, The Handmaid's Tale, Atlanta, and Legion. If you also think I should not be recommending shows that aren't legally streaming in India, please like, share, and subscribe to the Film Companion channel. And if you have more reviews to give me, you can give it right here in the comments or tell me on all my social media at Taneja Main Hoon. Kyunki Taneja Main Hoon, Mark Idhar Hai.